match focus on Lionel Messi. A hat-trick in his last game, will he prosper once more? We'll have the action on EA TV. Well, just the sort of weather the fans were hoping for this evening, it's absolutely ideal. I'm Derek Ray, in position to bring you live match commentary, and my expert analyst, as always on these occasions, is Stuart Robson. And we've got UEFA Champions League group stage action to bring you tonight. It's RB Leipzig against Paris Saint-Germain.
Well, Derek, this has the makings of a very good game. Great atmosphere, some top-class players, and a perfect pitch. I'm excited by this one.
Let's have a look at the starting 11 for Leipzig. Petr Gulácsi is the goalkeeper of choice. Vinny Orban plays with Nordi Mukiele in the fullback positions. And André Silva is the lone striker. And here is the initial 11 for Paris Saint-Germain. Gianluigi Donnarumma stands between the posts. Marquinhos plays alongside Sergio Ramos in central defence. Jorginho Wijnaldum starts alongside Idrissa Gueye in central midfield. And the main threat in attack today should be Kylian Mbappe. Oh, he looks threatening, but the danger averted for now. And the referee has decided to award the free kick to PSG. Well, a foul, but no yellow card at this early stage, in the opinion of the referee.
Well, he might just be lucky it's so early on. He'll have to be careful now.
Oh, he's gone for goal! Just can't get it past the wall. A go. Superb block. Well, that's a really good authoritative tackle. Throw in here. And space to cross it. Oh, he's given it. Penalty. And an opportunity now for them to jump in front. Well, no card handed out, but quite a few upset players out there, Stuart.
Well, he's made a genuine attempt to play the ball. So penalty, yes. Yellow card, no.
Can he make it 1-0? And he steered it wide of the post!
Well, he's just overdone it. That's a really poor penalty.
Well, back when the draw was made, no one really expected the home side to be quite as competitive. It looked as though they would struggle in this group, Stuart.
Well, they've been excellent so far. They've worked hard, they've been organised, and they've played some great football. But they just have to keep it going now.
And the ruling is offside here. Marcel Zabica. André Silva with it. Could be! He can't hold on to it. Keeper, meanwhile, looks to the heavens.
Well, here's the replay. Yes, it's a decent shot, but the goalkeeper has to do a lot better there. He's parried it out into a dangerous area, and suddenly the ball's in the back of his net. It's poor goalkeeping, you have to say.
And they will make the change now. And back underway, 1-0 it is. He's managed to lose his marker. And the keeper's hand does the trick.
Well, what a good piece of goalkeeping that was. But the equaliser can't be long in coming, surely.
Can they hit on the break? Well, this is not ideal for him. He was booked earlier. Perfectly positioned to take it away. He could really get at the opposition. Oh, maybe the equaliser. Oh, really sound goalkeeping.
Well, that's such a good save, isn't it? How did he keep that one out?
Well, opting for the short corner. Trying something different with his movement, Verratti. Decided to come in from the flank. Giving it a try. Terrific block. Verratti. Regained possession. And he read it superbly. Messi takes it on and foiled only by the crossbar. Just the clearance that was called for. Let's get the latest on the injury situation from our pitch side man, Jeff Shreves.
I've got to say, he landed really heavily on his shoulder there and looks like he's in severe pain. But he looks less concerned than the bench, who are worried about him. I think he'll stay on.
Cheers, Jeff. Great opportunity, it's gone in, a goal for PSG beyond the goalkeeper to square things up.
Well, here's the replay, and just look at that power, that's almost unstoppable, that's a great strike.
Back underway, level pegging, one goal apiece in this game. And intercepting it. Marcel Zabica. Dani Olmo with it. A good and fair challenge. Now putting it wide from there, disappointing. So 2 minutes of stoppage time to be added on. Mukiele. Dani Olmo. Can he finish this? And the whistle is sounded for half-time in this game. Well, here's the truth of the matter. Struggles galore for Neymar, and that's not... Underway then in the second half of this Champions League group stage confrontation. Mbappe takes aim and a goal here. There it is. They've done it.
Well, this is a brilliant strike, as you can see. He hits it with so much power, the keeper had no chance. Fantastic finish.
Leipzig get us moving again. A quick reply required after the disappointment of conceding. Marcel Zabica. And it's a quality pass. And how well the keeper did.
Well, that's just exceptional. He reacted so quickly there.
Well, the crowd are doing their bit. Can they find the equaliser here?
Now, sending it in. Well, you're not going to bamboozle the goalkeeper with a corner like that. And a goal has gone in one of the other matches. Alex Scott will tell us more.
It's a goal for Manchester City. It's all even Stevens at 1-1 with 54 minutes played.
And on the back of that particular challenge, will the referee let the matter rest there? And a yellow card it's going to be, Stuart.
Yeah, the ref's got that right. It's a yellow card all day long.
Told he made it rather straightforward for the keeper.
Well, he knows it. That is a real waste of a great opportunity. Well, that save has kept him in this game. They now need to create one or two chances of their own.
Got to it easily, the keeper. Well, to Alex, apologies for having to interrupt you just then. Just to confirm, Manchester City did find the net in that match, and it's level now at one goal apiece. And blocked for now. Can he find the net? Oh, covering up defensively. Oh, it comes to nothing in the end. Really should have made more of that. Well, they are committed to making the substitution here. Kevin Kampel. The ball with Zabica. Just a quick reminder, we've got Champions League group stage action for you to look forward to here on EA TV. It's RB Leipzig versus Paris Saint-Germain.
I like the look of that game. The atmosphere is always good inside that stadium, and two very good teams.
Now PSG moving the ball forward. What can they do from here? And it's two for him today. A masterful performance. The defenders unable to stop him.
Well, here's the replay, and just look how quickly they break forward once they win the ball back. But I don't think the keeper should be beaten in his near post quite so easily. I think that's stoppable.
So the ball is moving again. We've been treated to four goals. 3-1 the score. Well, as we approach full-time, Paris Saint-Germain absolutely coasting. You can't really tackle like that and expect to get away with it. Booking to come, you would think. Well, a yellow card it is, and not too many complaints.
No, he can't argue with that. He's been warned.
And the keeper had the measure of that one. He might be able to carve something out. It must go in, surely. And denied by the keeper. Impressive. 10 minutes to go. Marcel Zabica. Nordi Mukiele. This looks promising. Opportunity it is. And he's fired it against the post. Oh, yes! What a classy goal! And make no mistake, there aren't many in the game who would have the confidence to even try it.
Well, just look at this. He's so bright in the box. He's first to the ball and then a decent finish. It's a good bit of play.
Well, back underway, and a glut of goals here. 3-2. Well, racing past his man, and the advantage is with PSG. In search of space. Well, that effort was always going wide. He's not going to be best pleased with himself. PSG are going to switch things around on the personnel front. Nkunku. The ball with Kampel. They're showing good. A real opening now. And the flag was up in good time. It's offside.
Well, he should have realised that was going to be offside. That's a poor decision to play that pass.
Orban. Nkunku has it. And here they come, still pressing for an equaliser. And there's the final whistle, and we can confirm a victory for Paris Saint-Germain. What did you think of their overall display?
Well, Derek, they didn't dominate the game by any means today, but overall they had the better of the chances and just about deserved their win.
Well, choose your descriptive word where Kylian Mbappe is concerned.